data item B, and here is also reading data value B. So which is reading first, or initial value of data item B read by which transaction? Here T1 is reading first, then T1, then T2, and schedule 2 here is a read operation on data item B. Here read operation on data item B, which one is reading first the initial value of B? T1. So our first condition is also matched, both in the both transaction T1 is reading first or initial value. Check the second condition, last write operation. Here this is the write operation, this is the write operation. Which transaction is writing at the last? This one, means transaction T2 in schedule 1. T2 is writing at the last in schedule 1. Check for the schedule 2. This is the write operation on data item B. Here this is the write operation data item B. Which one is the last writing? Here this transaction T2 is writing at the last. So our second condition is also satisfied. Check for third condition, producing and consuming. Here B1 is read by transaction T1 and write, means modify the value of B, which is read by transaction T2. Here transaction T2 is reading, so T1 follows T2. In schedule 1, check for schedule 2. Here V1 is read and write, means do some modification, which is read by this operation. So here also we can say T1 producing and T2 is consuming. T1, T2 means our third condition is also match. All three condition is match for both the data item A and B. So we can say our schedule S1 and S2 are view equivalent. S1 view equivalent to S2. Ultimately, we can say our schedule S1 and S2 are view equivalent. Let's check for this example as well. Here three schedule S1, S1, S2 and S3. Check for schedule 1, S1 and S2 are view equivalent or not. Again, for data item here, data items only one data item A. For check data item A, schedule 1 and schedule 2. Our first condition is for initial value read by which transaction. Here in schedule 1 is a read operation on data item A, and no other read operation data item A. So we can say T1 is reading initial value. In schedule 2, this is the read operation on data item A, and no other read operation. So we can say the only read operation which is transaction T1 is reading initial value of data item A. The first condition is satisfied. Second condition, which transaction is right at the last. Here two write operation on data item A, this one and this one. Which operation perform at the last? This one, which belongs to transaction T1. So we can say transaction T1 is writing at the last. In this schedule 2, two write operation on data item A, this one and this one. Which operation perform at the last? This operation, and which is belongs to transaction T2. And this condition is not satisfying. In this schedule, T1 is writing at the last on data item A. Here T2 is writing at the last on transaction in schedule 2. So we can, our second condition is not met. So we can say S1 and S2, S1 and S2 is not view equivalent. This two schedule is not view equivalent. Check for schedule 2 and schedule 3. Schedule 2 and schedule 3 on data item A. The first condition, which transaction is read first or initial value of data item A. Here this is the read value and no other read operation. So we can say in schedule 2, transaction T1 is the read first or initial value of data item A. Here only one read operation which is performed by transaction T1. Our first condition is satisfied. Second condition, which transaction is writing at the last. Here two write operation and transaction T2 is writing at the last in schedule 2. In this, there is two write operation, and which operation is writing at the last? Here this one, and this belongs to transaction T1. Again, this our second condition is not matching, so we can say our schedule 2 and schedule 3 are not view equivalent. Check for schedule S1 and S3. Schedule S1 and S3 are equivalent or not? Let's check. First check read initial value, which operation, which transaction is reading initial value. Here transaction T1 is reading initial value of data item A. In schedule 3 only one read operation which is belongs to transaction T1, so we can say this one is reading the initial value. Second condition is writing, which transaction is writing at the last. Here two write operation and transaction T1 is write at the last, so transaction T1. In this schedule two write operation and with writing at last T1, our second condition is true. Sorry, this belongs to one and this belongs to one. Sorry, this is one. This is one. So our second condition is also satisfied in the both schedule S1 and S3. Transaction T1 is writing at the last. The third condition is writing and reading. Here transaction T1 is read, write, and now what is write. So there is no following this case, and in this writing and reading, transaction T2 is writing or modification something which is read by transaction T1. Is here T2 follows T1, but in transaction T1 no such case, so we can say our third condition is not matching here. So schedule S1 and S3 is not view equivalent because it is not matching all three conditions.